right, everybody. Thanks for coming out to SecIC this month. We're going to go ahead and start the 101. Do we have any newcomers tonight? Can you raise your hand? Yeah. Okay. We'll have some stickers out here for a minute, so you can grab those. So on tonight's agenda, we're doing the 101, then Matt Brenton will do the news, and then Jeff will talk about fuzzing, and Josh is going to talk about Tor. So what is SecIC? We're a CitySec, unaffiliated collection of like-minded security professionals. We meet to discuss about information security in a non-work, non-vendor setting. We meet the fourth Wednesday every month, so that's fairly easy to remember, and we are a registered 501c3 nonprofit. So, we stole this from SecDSM, who stole it from SecKC down in Kansas City. We believe that you should challenge ideas, not people. So, try to stay out of arguments and think about the ideas and whatnot. Okay. We'll have talks up here. The bathrooms are in the back. The men's is on the right when you're looking in the back, and the women's is on the left. We do have speakers up here, we do ask that you not talk while they're speaking. That's fine if you want to have a conversation. Just go ahead and go downstairs and continue that. So tonight we do not have a sponsor, but we are looking every month for sponsorships. If you or your company or some vendor that you know that would like to have that opportunity to sponsor us, please come find one of the board members. And there's a picture of us. The four of us you'll see are right there. Go ahead and find us if you'd like to take that sponsorship opportunity. You will notice a minor change, if you can read that. So we had our quarterly board meeting last month, and the president and the vice president did swap. So Matt Brenton is now the president of SecIC, and Zach is the vice president. Besides that, there weren't any other changes. Yep. You can find us at secic.org. There's our email. Our Twitter is sec_IC. And then to see the recorded talks, you can go to bit.ly/secic_YouTube. If you want to get a hold of us when we're not at the meeting, the best way is on Slack. We have over 112 people there. We do have pretty good discussions about information security and whatnot. So go ahead and join that. We do have a few shared channels with our sister SEC in Des Moines as well. So go ahead and sign up for that. Upcoming conferences, I know that several of us from SecIC and also from SecDSM will be going to Circle CityCon. That's in Indianapolis. That's not this weekend, but the weekend after. The weekend after that is BurrCon in Minneapolis. And then we take kind of a break for late June and July, and then Hacker Summer Camp starts up in Las Vegas. We do have we work with SecDSM to offer scholarships to different conferences. What that means is we've competed either together or individually to win black badges at conferences, and what that black badge allows you to do is enter those conferences for free for life. So if you're a student or you're just having a rough time financially, we do offer those out to our members. So if there is a conference you'd like to go ahead and go to that link to apply. Next month's agenda, we don't have any talks yet, so if you'd like to give a talk, go ahead and either let us know tonight, go to the website, there's a submit a talk link, it's 3 or 4 questions, fill that out, and we'll get you scheduled. All right, up next, we have the merch monger, which is me. Well, here's Zach. We have patches for sale for $5. we have blockchains for sale. I believe the suggested donation for that is $10, or blockchains, $5. And I think we have shirts coming up here within the next couple months. We're looking at doing another batch of shirts. All right, so we're going to go over the financial transparency. If you're new tonight, like I said, we are a 501c3. We are 100% transparent with our finances. So the previous balance last month was $900. Whoops. Our expenses, I forgot to update that. The pizza is always a month behind, so it was $125. We purchased some new AV equipment, for the microphones, the right angle AV equipment. That puts us at $155 loss there on the expenses. And then income, we had a $5 donation. We volunteered at the B-Sides Iowa, where they were nice enough to give us $250 to help out with the recordings for that. So we really do appreciate that. And then we had $20 in Amazon Smile. So total income of $275. So that puts us at now a current balance of $1,020. And I'm going to go ahead and let Matt go ahead and do the news. Oh, and then the other thing. So tonight, a little bit different. So the pizza oven is broken. So what we decided to do was we're going to do wings and fries. So we'll have plenty. They're sauceless wings. So go ahead, have at it. If we need more, we can order more. That's fine. But they're going to have also all different kinds of sauces, so you'll be able to pick and choose how you want to do that.
Alrighty. Am I padded still?
No. Yes, no. Okay, there we go. All right, so news. First one. Finally, sounds like Facebook is actually kind of having some repercussions to their terrible security practices. This happened kind of late last month, I think it was. Anyway, they were hit with 3 privacy investigations in a single day, finally. Ireland is looking into the breach of hundreds of millions of Facebook and Instagram user passwords that were stored in plain text on their servers. Let's remember that. Canada is taking them to federal court over the Cambridge Analytica privacy scandal. So again, different privacy scandal, same Facebook. And then New York Attorney General is actually looking into the 3rd Facebook scandal, where they were collecting user email addresses. And then I think that was the one where they were requiring new users to give their email credentials, and then they were scraping their contacts. So yeah, pretty shady stuff. So hopefully Facebook has to pay a lot of money for that sort of thing. All right, next one. It has now been 26 days since Brian Krebs doxed a researcher for a technical argument. In that time, he's deleted the offending tweet, released multiple stories, and tweeted numerous times, yet no apology. I put this one in here. It's not really news per se, but just wanted to call Mr. Krebs out for kind of an awful practice, doxing a security researcher over a technical disagreement. The tweet over there is, we now break from the live coverage of Kevin Mitnick blocking the entire internet to remind you that Krebs has still not apologized for being a privacy advocate only when it suits him. So Kevin Mitnick got involved. If you guys don't know what happened, check it out. It's pretty interesting. But it is pretty shameful that Brian Krebs still hasn't addressed it. He just pretends it never happens. So we remember. By Mitnick. Yeah. Yeah. Zach and I got blocked by Mitnick. Yes. Okay. WhatsApp hacked, and Bloomberg drops another InfoSec flop of a story. So Bloomberg's original story was WhatsApp hacked shows end-to-end encryption is largely pointless. I think a lot of people had a kind of a similar response, but I pulled MalwareTech's response up there where he says, vehicle hit by Hellfire missile shows that wearing your seatbelt is largely pointless. Because it's really not, you know, saying that an endpoint was compromised does not mitigate the fact, or doesn't say that encryption doesn't matter. It's just completely different. So anyway, what happened is the NSO group, which is known for their Pegasus mobile spyware, they're an Israeli company. They've been kind of fingered as the source of this recent hack. I don't know if that's actually been proven, but I think it's yesterday, just yesterday, Amnesty International announced that they are actually suing in the Israeli Ministry of Defense to force the revocation of the NSO Group's export license, which would essentially make it so that they could not export their products. So be interesting to see where that goes. Next one, Chinese hacking group was using exploits and attack tools developed by the NSA a few months before another group released the tools. So that came out. Symantec released that. They're calling it Buckeye, also APT3 Gothic Panda. So they believe, they speculate that China was able to capture the NSA tools being used against them, determine what the exploits were being used against them, and then turn around and use those same exploits. And they said that they saw this APT using the double pulsar backdoor in March of 2016. And the Shadow Broker's leak of that tool did not happen until August of 2016. So that's pretty interesting. Kind of changes the perception of the kind of U.S. only cyber weapons there. So last one, FXMSP chat logs reveal the hacked AV companies in the code for sale breach. So this one, I'm still, you know, I was skeptical when this came out. I think it's interesting that this story hasn't really gone any further than this, and it's been about a week. But Bleeping Computer obtained exclusive unredacted evidence from this the researcher, which is AdvIntel, showing that this hacker collective, they named their victims. So it's Symantec, McAfee, and Trend Micro. Two of the AV companies have since responded. Again, it's been a week, and I haven't seen it. I looked for an update, and I couldn't find one. Symantec denied being breached, saying that they needed more proof. And AdvIntel said that they also don't have the proof that Symantec was breached. I'll jump down to the third one. McAfee has neither confirmed nor denied a breach. Kind of glossed over that, but Trend Micro is kind of the interesting one. They went ahead and said, yeah, we were compromised, but it was a single testing lab network that was accessed and low-risk debugging info was obtained. AdvIntel, they disagree with that. They say that they have evidence that 30 terabytes, including source code of their product, was stolen. And I think there was another Risky Business was reporting that at some point the hackers were sharing that they had access to the domain controllers for Trend Micro. So be really interesting to see what the fallout is of this. Again, I'm kind of surprised at the lack of updates on this one. So, all right, lastly, jobs. Anybody have an opening at their company they want to advertise, or anyone looking for a job? Yeah, Paul. Web app tester. What level of experience? Senior? More senior? Okay. You'll take a candidate who's willing to learn. Okay. How do they apply to that job? Do they contact you? All right. Talk to Paul on Slack. All right. Full remote. Very little travel. Awesome. All right. Yeah, that's a good gig. Anyone else looking? Anybody looking? Anybody have another opening? All right. With that, we'll take a break. Looks like we got some more food up here. So go ahead and get some food, grab a drink, and our first talk will be in 15 minutes.